Gee, Shrek. Man, we're out in it. We've waited till about noon. We've been dealing with crashes on the highway. 17 has just been an absolute nightmare today. Even if I didn't want to hike today, I can't get turned around. The highway is completely shut down on 17. Two lanes back all the way to Rock Springs. You know, we're back at one of my favorite locations, and we had to pick at 107 degrees to come do this. So it's going to be a nasty hike. It's going to be bushwhacking. It's going to be extremely difficult. It also burnt up here. They had some type of fire. Don't know what that was from, but we got a mess to deal with, I think, today. And so today we're going to try to figure out which challenge we're going to take on how we're going to attack this. And we got to go straight up. And I've been up this twice, or I should say, I've been up this once, and we came up and we went up one way and we came down one way. And you know, neither one of these ways was pleasant. And both ways were bushwhacking. So what we're gonna see up there is one of the most incredible places ever. But it's gonna be hot, it's gonna be nasty, but you know what? The surprise at the end of this, you know, hopefully is gonna be spectacular. So what I'm gonna do is, I think what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to try to reverse the way that I went up last time. And you know, I don't know though, because all this area is burnt that it would have to traipse through. And that would be extremely nasty, other than maybe, it might be a little easier walking actually. But I hate fires, man. You know, make sure also, if you have a vehicle and you're off-roading, do not park your vehicle in high grass, because what happens is the heat from your vehicle can catch fire to that grass. So anyway, look at this mess, right? That's the last thing you want to do, is be responsible for something like that. I mean, you know, the devastation on the landscape, and also the devastation with the wildlife. I mean, and you know, you might put some of these areas in jeopardy, and you sure wouldn't want to do that either. So we're going to try to start working our way up through here and figure out which way to go on this journey that we're going to do today. Now, the hike is not going to be long, but the hike is going to be difficult. And so I can already feel this summer heat hiking, and we're going to work our way through here and see if we can find a better trail to get up here. It's kind of funny how you can tell how they definitely, you know, make their boundaries. Pretty intriguing. A job that I don't want, that I have a lot of respect for people that do, that fight these forest fires. Man, no fun at all. Kudos to you guys. Now look at that perimeter line that they drew up across there. Isn't that incredible how it looks like they dropped something from the sky to be able to make sure that there's a fire retardant there. You know, the funny thing is, we got a really good trail going through here. And it's extremely hot today, I can tell you that. Look at this devastation. I don't know how this started, but it's terrible. It really is. And you know, I'm not even sure exactly which way that we're working through here. This is a whole nother deal for me. So this is a different route than I took even last time. And I'm gonna try to work our way up through here across that ridge. Look at that. Yeah, it's gonna be a warm one today by the time we get done, but you know, hey, I couldn't go home if I wanted to. You know, the traffic is completely stopped on 17. 17 is a pretty crazy highway, really. If you're not from here, it's high speed, high impact. So let's take a gander. You know, one thing I don't have to worry about is, you know, this is not a place that a lot of people are going to be tracing up and down. So not going to be a lot of places that you're going to climb straight up. So it's pretty unbelievable and probably one of the most incredible locations that that I've been a part of. Now, we're gonna have a little leg check today because, you know, I consciously was like, okay, you're gonna be bushwhacking today. So, short pants, long pants. And I was like, man, it's gonna be so hot today. I do not wanna wear long pants. But then I was like, well, you know you're bushwhacking. So, now what? Well, I opted for the short pants. We'll find out if that was a bad idea or not. We're not hiking for any kind of time today because, you know, even if I got done now, I can't get down 17. There ain't no way off 17 at all. There's no way. So you're just gonna have to deal with it. So now it does look like some trails. Now, I don't like this first ravine I've got myself into, but I definitely see that there's a way up and in. You know, my glasses see that red there, and it's like, it almost looks surreal here, to be honest with you. It really does. But you know, from what I'm looking at, I think I got a better angle to get up here than I did last time I did this. So, you know, I've got another ravine to go down, but it's gonna be really hard to tell which way to go and how to do this. So this is what I got going on today, and we're lone wolfing it today. You know, I didn't get around till later. Had some work I had to get done. So, you know, we picked the hottest time of the day. I sat in traffic on another wreck, you know, that was not, the road was shut down. So let's see where this goes and how bad it is. And you know, my legs got pretty tough to bushwhacking. The skin did, to be honest with you. So we'll see where that works here. So we're gonna get it refreshened up, I got a feeling, here real quick. Now we gotta go straight up that. It's gonna be fun. Maybe not. Maybe there's an easier way to come right down this area right here and up. Well, there is a trail. It was a better trail for sure. You know, regrettably, I've got a path there. I could have taken that one up and across. And I can take this one up and over. And I really don't think there's a hell of a lot of difference between. I never thought before I hiked this that I had any real options. I all thought it would be straight up. And so far, this is not bad. Forehead is starting the uphill burn. So it started to sweat it up a little bit. Got plenty of water, got no hurries today. You know, whatever time it takes, it takes. Like I said, I can't get back on the highway anyway. I may try a second location. Hell, on this highway, I could do four or five recaps because there are some places up here that are just spectacular that I'd like to take another look at, like today. So, you want to know my favorite place? It's where you're going, to my favorite place. But it's not a gimme up that hill. We're gonna have to work it. But you know, we've done it before. I feel really, so far, this trail side that I'm going on, it's a lot better than the last times. And you know, the way we did it last time was not pleasant, up or down. So, and this is not gonna be pleasant, but I'm hoping it's not terrible. There's my turkey hawk. They all come to see me, whether that's good or bad. Whew. Let's get on up that hill, or let's get to that ridge, and then you take a break. What I like to do is just pick places. You know, I can't breath-wise just climb right up the top of that like some guys can. So I just give myself, like, okay, make it to that rock, make it to this rock, you know, and then rest, because you know, you still got to come down regardless. And coming down, as crazy as it sounds, is a lot harder than going up. I usually never fall up, but I have fell down on occasion. Got my first thorn in the side of my leg. Welcome to bushwhacking Arizona. That looks so surreal with that suppressant spray on those cactus. Well, Harry's gonna tell me, don't be breathing so loud, but I'm breathing pretty loud. And, you know, I'm about halfway up, but you know, distance-wise, I'm less, but time-wise, you know, it's a steep-ass hike. It's, I'm not gonna haul two cases of beer up here and drink. That's not gonna happen. So, but I do see trails of other people who've actually been up here. And the last time or the first time I came up here, you know, I didn't see any. And I know a few people have been up here, and I'll be really interested to take a look at it and see how it looks. It's a big deal to me, it really is. So I'm going to take my time. As you can see, the sweat's coming, but it's going to at 107, especially when you leave as late as I did. But, you know, I do train in this stuff. So if I get a feeling that I can't go any farther, even if I'm not up there, I'll turn around. Man, you can hike this anytime. You don't have to hike it today if you ain't got it. So always be smart. And I'm glad one thing, I'm glad I got my good shoes on, because this one would suck in a bad pair of shoes. It would suck. I think I got a little trail over that way. Might take a walk and then go across that top instead of straight up. So it looks maybe a little more pleasant. But as you can see, it's definitely a real hike. That's why people drone this and they don't hike it, which I get it. But well, you hear me puffing now. I don't know if you guys do this, but I play little games, like I'm gonna do 50 paces. And then, you know, try to do 70, or gonna do 25 and try to do 50. And just like a minute ago, I did 100. And, you know, for some reason it works for me. I'm not gonna tell you this, not kind of super to crazy, but you know, as far as just pounding up this thing nonstop, I'm not gonna get that done. You know, heat wise, I'd already be up there. I can already tell you that. I mean, but that's not that big a difference in reality. I'd say when we get over 100, getting the 105s, 107s, then you know, it's about like adding 20 pounds on you. I'd say every 15 degrees, something like that. And that's just my estimation, but I know how my body is. And I hike enough to know that when you get up here and you start climbing altitude like this, it's definitely a tough deal. And, but you know, it's what you gotta do. I mean, if you wanna get up there and see it, and you gotta hike it. So I'm gonna put you away and give you a view of what I'm seeing up here. I don't know what time I left. I'm probably thinking 45, 50 minutes today, guessing. Don't know that to be sure though. but there's other things I'm looking at too. I'm actually looking at that ridge over there with a lot of interest. A lot of interest. So I'll be looking at that side as well, because I think there's two locations on that other ridge that I want to go to. Now I got to drive another, I don't know, God, a ton of miles to get over there. But it's definitely interesting when you go to a place, you got to look for other places, because usually there's not just one single one. But wow, talking ain't going to get us up this hill. So let's tighten up the shoelaces and let's get up here. Thank goodness for the breeze. Thank you. I appreciate that. I tell you what, that last 100 yards, man, you know, really not feeling the heat. Like, you know, I got a little breeze, so if you get a little breeze, that, man, that's life and death up here. Looking down, see where, how far I've come, how high, and really rough terrain, all this volcanic rock and all these mesas, the Black, the Prairie Mesa, all these mesas up here, all of Agua Fria. Probably some of the hardest hiking I've ever done. This is not as bad as some of the stuff in Agua Fria, but man, it's still tough. Got to get right up there, and you're going to see one of the most beautiful sights, in my opinion, historically and ancient, in Arizona, and you're not going to want to miss this. You know, this channel is completely fueled on Patreon. And I love doing this, but it's so expensive to do it. And if you'd like to help, please donate to Patreon and help us continue to not only help me explore, okay, but also to keep Arizona open. I mean, there's a big concern going around that, you know, the way they're going to manage these locations like this, for example, is to shut them down. And I'm so opposed to that. Now, I have a proposal for preservation, and we're in discussions right now with different groups out here that can help. But it's going to take all of us to do it. It's going to take money to do it. I hate to say that, but that's where we're focused and heading, is to keep Arizona open. Keep the Southwest open. This is our land. Look at this. This is all our land. And your children and my children and your children's children should be able to see this. But we got to get up there, and we got to get this last, I'd say, 40, 50 yards, and we're going to see some of the coolest stuff that you're ever going to be able to see. It's just going to be me and you, and again, that's a big deal to me, is to be able to come out here and not be in a tour group or walking a paved trail. I mean, part of this adventure, as you're seeing with me today, is coming out here on our own time. And our own schedule. How cool is that? These black rocks are getting extremely hot, so I'm going to try to make a plan, play a little head game with myself. You know, 50 steps up, 50 seconds off, 50 steps up, and they're probably at about 5 or 10 of those, I can be up there. Come on, join me if you will. Phew, let's get going. Hey, look at that wall, man. That's the greatest wall in the open out there, anywhere in Arizona I've ever seen. That is the pinnacle right there. It doesn't get any better than that wall. That is just gorgeous. I'm so excited to get up there. I'm way up there, but boy, I tell you what, this has taken its toll today. I wonder how many stewards come up here. Good question, I bet. Good news is I came up here for them. You know, I'm probably getting ready for a battle in this state with a lot of different sanctions. And what a better day to go up here to 107 degrees to show them that, you know, I'm ready and I'm preparing. And, you know, I'm not afraid to go out in it. And I'm not afraid of war for a cause. It's just. And I believe keeping this state open is a justifiable cause. I think I'm going to take a shortcut that way. Maybe. Things looks like a little softer, easier way. And I'll tell you what, right now, I could use a softer, easier way. Ain't hauling beer cans up here. Damn. Man, I'm still in awe of that. That is just ridiculous. I mean, that wall is so impressive. It's unbelievable. It really is. It's just unbelievable. It's a work of art. It really is. And to see it stand against the Arizona sky, you know, makes me proud to be from here. And, you know, let's go take a look and see what the art looks like on these rocks. And also, man, I'm getting, my ass is getting extremely hot on this black rock. Holy smoke. Okay, now I'm rested and up here. So let's take a look, start wandering down here. Look at that wall. A little lightheaded sitting here. Look how incredible that is. Wow, I'm really lightheaded. So I better take it easy and take it slow. Stay hydrated. And then let's take this journey together. That beautiful piece right there, archaic piece on the corner. Look how worn it is. Another one over there. So there's a lot of rock art right through here. Right here, there's a 1916. You know, I also look at when this graffiti was done. So 1916, man, that's a long time ago, right? Getting a little dizzy. I'm gonna have to sit down for a minute. The drive up that hill in this heat definitely took its toll on me today. Look at that wall though. How crazy is that? I'm gonna take extreme caution up here by myself. I tell you what, these rocks are smoking hot. Nice piece right there. More work down there on those rocks. Beautiful piece down there. Okay, are you guys ready? See one of the most fabulous sights to me? Look at that. Look at that wall. That is crazy. How cool that is. If we climb up here on these rocks and get up here, experience that work of art firsthand. How beautiful is that? Man. Unbelievable. That is absolutely incredible.